that actually the social skills is very important when we stay with our social in our society. So the writing, reading, and the mathematics that you said at the first time, it's just one indicator to show that children are ready to school for learning in school. But more than that, they have many competencies, like 100 competency that we need to support them along their readiness, along their development. Yes, that. It means like when you see the blueprint of the art, the architecture, right? When you're gonna build a house, so not just have the roof or just the pillar or just the door. The house is many. They have many components to make the house is completely, yeah, something like that. The same to stood, right?
So there's many part in curriculum, not only the activities, not only about the goals, but the strategies, everything inside the curriculum. And also the design of the class, you can add in the curriculum. Yeah, the site plan of the class, like where's the position of the art center, or where's the position of the language center, like that. It's also inside the curriculum.
Yes.
Jadi curriculum itu kalau kayak di rumah, kayak rumah itu ada kerangkanya kan, ada tiangnya, ada apa itu fondasinya di bawah, batu-batu. Nah, bagian-bagian itu tuh bagian-bagian dari curriculum. Makanya di dalam kurikulum itu bukan hanya indikator perkembangan, bukan hanya aktivitas, hari itu misalnya pembukaan, pembukaan baca doa, terus penutupan, kegiatan inti, bukan hanya itu. Tapi semua bagian itu adalah kurikulum. Bahkan sampai desain ruangan itu juga adalah kurikulum. Even the relationship between teachers and parents also the invisible curriculum.
Right.
Yeah. Sampai hubungan antara guru dengan orang tua itu adalah curriculum. Jadi bukan cuma role teacher di kelas, bukan cuma pengelolaan, tapi sampai komunikasi efektif antara orang tua dengan guru itu kurikulum namanya, tapi invisible kurikulum, maksudnya dia bukan dalam bentuk buku panduan kurikulum, tapi itu termasuk kurikulum. Seperti itu. Is there any question? I want someone give a question. It's a must. Ayo. Andrianto.
Ya, Bu.
Ya, silakan. Kalau ada pertanyaan harus bertanya atau boleh dicatat dulu. I give you 5 minutes to write down the questions, and I want all of you give a questions. Ya, dikasih waktu 5 menit.
Sebelumnya saya mau bertanya dulu, Ibu sudah dari mana ya, Bu?
Oh, Miss Nat, where are you from? He asked where are you from.
Okay. I'm from Thailand. The country. Yeah. Yeah. A little bit. Yeah.
Above.
Yeah, above a bit. Yes. Right.
It's very far from Gorontalo. It's about 5 hours, 3 hours We 3 hours from Gorontalo to Jakarta, and it's about 2 hours from Jakarta to Thailand. It's about 5 hours.
Oh, yeah, I can imagine that. I went to Jakarta once and went to Negeri, Negerang, Semarang, Semarang. Sorry.
Oh, Semarang. Semarang is in Java, Central Java.
Oh.
It's also far from Jakarta, very far, actually. But it's also it's just a couple of minutes from by plane.
Oh.
It's about a day if you are going by bus or by car.
Maybe if after the COVID go out, I can visit you later.
Yeah.
Yes. Sure. Oh, and you can come to visit me in Thailand.
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
And your students too, please come.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. So kalau pandeminya udah berakhir, boleh datang ke Thailand. Amin.
Yeah.
Another question, Adrianto.
Ibu, boleh saya bertanya?
Ya, yeah, ya, yeah, please.
Ada
I'm sorry, your
menjelaskan tentang jalur-jalur yang dikeluarkan untuk
your voice suaranya hilang.
Halo Bu.
Halo.
Ya Bu.
Ya.
Halo.
Ya.
Halo.
Ya.
Kedengaran Bu?
Iya, kedengaran.
Ya, tadi Ibu kan menjelaskan tentang kurikulum PAUD. Menjelaskan tentang kurikulum PAUD itu jalur-jalur yang digunakan untuk aspek perkembangan. Nah, di saya juga searching di Google bahwa kurikulum itu perangkat atau program pendidikan yang diberikan oleh suatu lembaga. Kira-kira kurikulum yang berada di Indonesia ini sama, apakah sama dengan kurikulum yang berada di Thailand atau memang beda, Ibu?
Oh, oke. Okay. Kalau gitu kita tanya kondisi kurikulum di Thailand. Itu aja ya pertanyaannya ya. Oke. Okay. The question is about the definition of curriculum. You say that curriculum is a course line and he has read about the curriculum in internet that curriculum is the is a program for develop children. He asked about the kind of curriculum in Thailand, maybe about the national curriculum of Thailand. Yeah, what about the national curriculum of early childhood in Thailand?
Actually in Thailand we have the core curriculum that the Ministry of Education they have the board to set the core curriculum and they write it in the booklet and share this booklet to the teacher, the to every school, but every school have to develop their school curriculum that relate to the core curriculum too. So the idea of core curriculum is about the development, the subject activities, the principle or the goal that the goal that relate to the national plan, like the plan of that the national want to lead the young children or young student to the good way, the direct way, something like that. So when like such as I am a teacher in the school. I read the core curriculum and I have to adapt it to my context. And I can do some research a bit in my student about my student as like need assessment, and we have to concern about the materials or about the resource, about the management in our school, and about everything that we can set the new program if we can if we want to add some innovative idea or some our belief like the philosophy or our theory or something that we confident that it's gonna be good for our children, so we can make the new curriculum to use only our school in our school. But some teacher, if they don't want to set the new curriculum, they can use the core curriculum as that curriculum as that curriculum in that school too. It can be both choice of them to use it. Yes, but normally we have the problem about some teacher, many teachers have the depressed from the parents that you need to teach my children about reading, writing, and mathematics.
Same like as in Indonesia.
Right. Because they expect that skill too much.
Yeah.
We are fighting too. Actually fight a long time. So they can mix some teachers, so they have to survive in that school. They must make something like in our class, when children come, they can set activity in their idea, but they can give some homework, a piece of homework about writing or something that about alphabet to show that parent can teach children and connect something to write in easy word to. Yeah, they do like that. They do like that. Mm-hmm. Is it the same in Indonesia?
Yeah. In Indonesia also have it's like a standard booklet about the curriculum. But every school can start from the standard, but they can add the another curriculum, like for traditional, for culture, or international, if they some school have by license from international school like Singapore, Australia, like that, and they can mix also. They can mix the curriculum.
Okay.
And but the pressure, same as in Indonesia. Mm-hmm. So that I always say to my student that preschool is not for teaching them reading, writing, and mathematics. Not only that, but they have another aspect of development that's holistic and integrative.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The development aspect is not separate one of them, but they are integration, like gathering to develop together, and another aspect could improve another aspect also. Like if you make activities like play Play-Doh, or cooking, you not just stimulate their fine motor, but you can also develop their language by have new vocabularies from cooking. You can develop their cognition by if there's some activities like add some flour or add some water inside the bowl, you can count 1, 2, 3 like that. It's for your intelligence, for your cognitive aspect, for your cognition like that. And every aspect, it's holistic and integrative development, not just part by part like that. Yeah, I'm going to translate to my student. Okay. Yeah. Jadi kurikulum di Thailand itu sama seperti di Indonesia. Itu kayak ada booklet khusus untuk standar kurikulum yang isinya tentang aktivitas pengembangan setiap aspek perkembangan, sama seperti yang ada di Indonesia, sesuai dengan tujuannya negara sana. Kalau kita kan ada tujuan juga di tujuan nasional, kita kan juga ada gitu. Nah, kurikulum yang dibuat itu sesuai dengan tujuan nasional yang ada di Thailand. Kemudian, boleh dipakai berdiri sendiri, boleh dimix dengan, ditambah misalnya dengan kepercayaannya mereka. Misalnya kalau kayak kita ada sekolah Islam, atau misalnya ada sekolah khusus Nasrani gitu. Jadi kurikulum nasional digabung dengan kurikulum khusus keagamaan. Ada juga misalnya kalau kayak di kita ditambahkan dengan kebudayaan, atau misalnya ada kurikulum internasional, boleh digabung, boleh juga berdiri sendiri. Tapi harus tetap menggunakan kurikulum nasionalnya itu, nggak boleh dia cuma menggunakan kurikulum keagamaan aja, tapi tidak menggunakan kurikulum nasional, itu tidak boleh. Harus di-mix, harus digabung. Terus kemudian di sana juga ada tekanan ke guru sama seperti di Indonesia. Orang tua maunya anak-anak itu belajar calistung. Padahal pengembangan aspek-aspek perkembangan itu bukan hanya membaca, menulis, dan berhitung. Ada aspek-aspek lain. Dan aspek-aspek itu holistik, integratif, maksudnya setiap aspek itu saling menunjang aspek yang lain. Contoh, kayak tadi saya contohkan kalau lagi cooking, belajar masak, kayak bikin adonan donat misalnya. Waktu anak lagi nuangin air ke dalam mangkok dicampur dengan tepung, itu ada pengembangan kognitif. Menghitung misalnya 1, 2, 3, ada berapa sendok tepung yang dimasukkan dalam mangkok, ada berapa gelas air yang dituang, gitu. Kemudian mereka ada tambah kosakata baru juga tentang memasak, ada tepung, ada air, ada misalnya ada vanila misalnya, ada penambahan kosakata baru itu untuk pengembangan bahasa. Terus kemudian motoriknya jelas, kalau lagi bentuk adonan kan itu berarti untuk motorik halus. Tapi mereka nggak berdiri sendiri setiap aspek itu, saling menunjang, saling mendukung. Makanya disebutnya holistik integratif. Menyeluruh dan saling berhubungan. Seperti itu. Ada pertanyaan lain? Another question?
Ada, Bu.
Ya, please. Kalau boleh bahasa Inggris? Oke, boleh.
Belum bisa, Ibu.
belajar.
Pertanyaan saya, pertimbangan-pertimbangan Nur Ain Dolong Seda, Ibu.
Nur Ain?
Nur Ain Dolong Seda.
Oke. Ayo pertanyaannya.
Pertimbangan-pertimbangan apa saja yang harus dipersiapkan ketika akan melakukan perubahan atau pergantian kurikulum?
Oke. Udah, itu?
Iya, Ibu. Itu saja.
Ya. Oke. The question is, what kind of factors we must think about if we want to reconstruct the curriculum?
Okay.
Yeah.
In my point of view, I think it should be the factor about the ability or the need of the children.
Okay.
At first, if you want to create a curriculum, you need to analyze about your children first, okay. And you need to know the natural of your children, what they on the baseline of their ability, and the context that they live, like the family or the community or the culture or something like that,
mm-hmm.
And the language or the something, yeah, in their living real life. And after that, it should be something that you need to think about. Is a good way to develop your children. Like you may need to read about the research or innovative idea or some new knowledge that like today we learn a lot about the brain or about the thing that the children should develop to prepare to the next society. So the second is about something that you need to look for the future, that they can grow up and live in 10 years or next 20 years or something like that, to make them feel they are ready to succeed in their life or their learning. I think,
yeah, about the development of knowledge century technology,
right. All everything.
Yeah. Okay. I will translate and add some more explanation about it. Thank you.
Please. Yeah.
Okay. Tadi Nur Ain. Yeah. Tadi apa saja sih pertimbangannya kalau mau reconstruct the curriculum, maksudnya mau merubah atau memperbaiki atau apa namanya, mengembangkan kurikulum. Yang pertama itu yang harus menjadi baseline itu adalah kebutuhan anak, karakteristik anak. Anak itu yang penting. So that before we start the first year of learning in the school, we must do some observation to know about the children needs and children's characterization.
Right.
Jadi sebelum, makanya setiap ajaran baru itu sebulan, dua bulan pertama observasi awal, pengenalan dulu anak, masa orientasi lah kalau di sekolah ya, masa orientasi. Tapi masa orientasi di TK bukan kayak di kampus ya. Jadi pengenalan, masa pengenalan, anak mengenal sekolah, guru mengenal anak. Karena setiap anak kan beda-beda. Yang masuk tahun ini belum tentu sama karakteristiknya dengan tahun kemarin. Jadi makanya ada observasi awal, dikenali dulu kebutuhannya, minatnya, dan lain sebagainya, baru itu di apa namanya, disesuaikan dengan kurikulum. Nah, kemudian selain itu lihat juga kebudayaan. Apalagi kayak di Indonesia, khususnya kalau kayak di Jakarta ya, plural, banyak dari berbagai macam daerah. Kalau di Gorontalo masih nggak terlalu mayoritas ya, cuman misalnya yang masuk tahun ini kan kadang-kadang misalnya ada yang dari Jawa, tahun berikutnya misalnya ada yang dari Padang, itu kan ada perbedaan kebudayaan. Supaya tidak terjadi konflik, dilihat bagaimana penyesuaian kurikulumnya. Atau mungkin ada konten untuk multikulturalisme, multikultural. Kemudian faktor yang lain juga dilihat society mereka dari kelompok apa gitu. Jadi perlu penyesuaian. Kemudian ada juga lihat perkembangan zaman kita saat ini. Ali bin Abi Thalib pernah bilang jangan kita mengajarkan anak kita sesuai dengan zaman kita. Kita harus menyesuaikan zamannya anak itu. Karena waktu dulu misalnya saya lahir tahun 83, nggak ada internet, nggak ada handphone, cuma adanya TV hitam putih misalnya. Terus mau juga diberikan pola asuh yang sama dengan itu, kan nggak bisa. Apalagi sekarang internet. Internet is everywhere. Yes. Everywhere. Internet ada di mana aja. Kamu nongkrong di abnormal ada internet, di McD ada internet, gimana lagi. Semua punya wifi, di rumah ada wifi. Begitu mudahnya anak masuk ke dunia internet. Walaupun ada parental guide, tetap aja mereka bisa temu. Ada kasus anak masih SD atau SMP yang bisa membongkar website-nya, website-nya Badan Intelijensi di luar negeri, dia bongkar, dia hack website-nya. Padahal dia masih SD dan nggak pernah belajar tentang coding, nggak pernah belajar tentang IT. Nah, sebegitu mudahnya internet itu dimasuki oleh anak-anak. Makanya yang harus disesuaikan sekarang yaitu bukan melarang mereka untuk bisa mengenal internet, justru mereka harus bisa bagaimana caranya berdampingan dan menjadikan internet itu bermanfaat. Bukan hanya untuk hiburan, bukan hanya untuk main. Your hands wet. Bukan hanya untuk main, bukan hanya untuk lihat YouTube, bukan hanya main games yang kasar dan sebagainya, tapi konten-konten yang ada di internet itu bersamaan dengan pembelajaran bisa dilakukan dan bisa lebih bermanfaat. Nah, sekarang untuk penelitian saat ini lebih banyak peneliti-peneliti melakukan hal itu. Kalau untuk masalah dampak buruk internet dan lain sebagainya itu udah banyak penelitiannya. Tapi justru sekarang bagaimana justru teknologi, apalagi sekarang udah memasuk society 5.0. Kita revolution 4.0 aja belum kelar-kelar gitu. Maksudnya 4.0 still the issue, big issues in Indonesia. Yeah. Because there's some ruler place still can reach by internet. Also electricity. Yeah. There's so many village here electricity-less, you know. Yeah. They have the electricity only for 6 hours, and after that there's no electricity. You know, it's just in the night and in the morning they don't have the electricity.
Some part in Thailand.
Yeah.
Like in the hill, up to the north in Thailand. Oh. They need to use the solar cell to create the electricity in the daytime. Yes.
And it still be the community services program from our university to make some technology, like from waters or every kind of sources we can use to make the electricity. Jadi bagaimana mau revolusi 4.0 sementara di Jepang udah masuk society 5.0 gitu, karena di Indonesia memang masih jadi big issue itu, kayak listrik belum semua dapat listrik dengan baik. Listrik aja belum dapat, gimana mau dapat internet kan, gitu kan? Gitu. Jadi, ayo mahasiswa, sama-sama kita bikin program. Walaupun dari pendidikan anak usia dini, tetap harus punya program yang bisa membangun desa. Gitu. Di fakultas kita ada anggaran untuk program bina desa mahasiswa. Jadi bukan cuma dosen yang punya community services. Students juga punya community services. Bagaimana caranya? Bagaimana caranya learning di pandemic itu seperti apa gitu, yang enggak punya internet, enggak punya handphone, enggak punya listrik, itu gimana caranya supaya anak-anak tetap bisa belajar dan enggak ketinggalan. Jangan sampai ada loose generation. Oh, jangan sampai ada loose generation. Itu big no-no for the loose generation. Because of pandemic, and the generation will have a loss of learning, education. It's a big no-no. Jadi maksudnya jangan sampai itu semua bisa terjadi. Karena pandemi ini gak tahu sampai kapan. Dan bahkan ternyata saya pun mengalami gitu kemarin. Bagaimana rasanya harus berjuang hidup. Bernafas susah, demam tinggi, sakit semua badannya. Udah yang pokoknya udah pasrah diri. Apa yang akan kejadian besok kalau nggak inget anak-anak saya, tuh saya udah udah hilang pertahanan. Maksudnya saya, karena saya inget saya punya anak-anak masih kecil-kecil, jadi saya pokoknya berjuang gimana caranya supaya ini virus ini mati gitu, dan bisa nafas seperti biasa gitu. Jangan sampai karena pandemi terus ada kehilangan generasi, satu generasi di Indonesia, itu bahaya banget. Untuk satu tahun aja, kehilangan satu tahun aja itu udah mempengaruhi perkembangan kemajuan baik ekonomi, teknologi, dan lain sebagainya. Okay, another question? Or keep for next week because we still have another session.
Yes.
Yeah. Maybe next week you can talk about the high school.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. So I will prepare the slide.
Yeah. Because today we talk about the curriculum generally in early childhood education. So next week we can talk about the high school.
Yes.
Yeah.
Is there the high school apply in your town or some school?
Oh. Mm-hmm. In Gorontalo, there's no high school. But in Jakarta, I have met some school with high school approach.
Oh.
Yeah.
Let me show some pictures, some video.
Yeah.
my research.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah. Okay, student, ini sampai di sini. Saya kasih waktu untuk screenshot. Saya hitung sampai 10 ya. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Jadi nanti screenshotnya untuk bukti daftar hadir. For your present proof in our system, you must screenshot this meeting, okay? Ya, yeah. Disimpan dulu pertanyaannya lagi untuk minggu depan. I hope next week you can ask with English.
Okay. Good,
yeah. Good. Learning to speak. Mm-hmm. Learning to bridge. Talk about what everyone to ask about curriculum. About high scope. Minggu depan high scope ya. Boleh ditulis. Saya di now you can look for some news or article about high scope. You can read it. So next week you can ask about high scope to Miss Nat.
Okay, good.
You can write down. It's okay. You write down. You read the questions slowly. It's okay. But try it. Ask the question in English. Okay? Okay, student?
Okay.
Ya, nggak apa-apa ditulis, dibaca pelan-pelan. Yang penting belajar untuk bertanya menggunakan bahasa Inggris.
Yes.
Gitu. Minggu depan saya mau streaming YouTube, okay?
may I say something? Yeah. In Thailand, my students. The same too.
Yeah.
They are not confident to speak English, but actually they can read some and translate their English sentence or essay or something in Thai. So I sometimes enforce them to try. Yes. But at first, I assign them to sing a song, sing some song for me.
Yeah.
In English, yeah.
It's 2021, you know.
Right.
Globalization is very, very near.
Yeah.
Close, very close.
Right.
And, yeah.
We are the same. Maybe next time, we have some, I may bring my student to join the class.
Sure, sure. Yeah.
But, I need to ask them about the free time on Monday session too.
Okay.
Yes, maybe I will tell you later.
It's my pleasure. So they can know each other from Indonesia, from Thailand.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
They can be the buddy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, minggu depan kalau ada waktu, Miss Nat mau undang mahasiswanya juga yang dari Thailand. Jadi ayo belajar biar even you just say hi, good afternoon, or yes, no, it's okay.
Yes,
it's yang good penting start. Berani.
Yeah, right.
Ya, prepare ya minggu depan. Boleh ditulis pertanyaannya, disiapkan. Udah cari-cari dulu info-info tentang high scope. Nanti kalau ada pertanyaan, ditranslate ke bahasa Inggris. Baru ditanyakan, dibaca, itu nggak apa-apa. Minggu depan juga kalau misalnya jadi, ada muridnya Ibu Nat mau gabung dengan kita. Oke, guys. Open your mind. Oke, guys.
Oke, ma'am.
Oke, ma'am.
Kenapa Adrianto?
Terakhir bisa bertanya, ini bukan soal mata kuliah, cuman permasalahan absen yang kemarin, mem.
Kenapa?
Ada teman-teman saya juga bilang bahwa aturan itu kan ada pasal mem. Cuman lain mereka bilang ditaruh alfa mem.
Siapa yang taruh alfa? Siapa yang taruh absen itu kan kamu sendiri yang input. Bukan itu yang korek. Makanya saya bilang upload screenshot itu kamu sendiri yang absen. Dan saya tidak membuka-buka absen. Kalau yang hari ini saya belum setting. Dan saya juga belum buka yang minggu kemarin. Minggu kemarin itu kan saya sakit, nggak masuk.
Maksudnya minggu yang waktu pertama ibu masuk?
Nggak ada yang isi alfa.
Kemudian
sistem siap, ibu.
Nah iya, kalau misalnya makanya jangan lewat waktu untuk upload. Jangan lewat waktu, dilihat waktunya terakhir kapan, jangan sampai lewat tanggal itu. Kalau udah lewat nggak bisa disetting ulang. Tapi kalau satu hari misalnya sebelum waktunya ada masalah, langsung kasih tahu karena nanti mau dimundurin waktunya. Tapi kalau udah lewat waktunya nggak bisa disetting ulang. Setahu saya kalau nggak masuk dia kosong, nggak ada isinya alfa. Cuman tidak.
Iya ibu, itu waktu itu kan ibu suruh download materi saja. Terus ya, yang kebaca hadir hanya beberapa orang ibu, yang lain absennya kosong.
Yang lain masih kosong bu.
Udah nanti gampang itu. Yaudah, yang sekarang di screenshot pertemuan hari ini, terus di-upload screenshot-nya. Understand? Screenshot pertemuan hari ini. Terus screenshot-nya di-upload. Oke?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
Bu. Ya, oke. Okay, see you next week. And our session next week is about high school. Yeah. Okay, not see you next week. Bye.
Okay. Bye.
Sawadee ka. Sadiha. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.